The Sam Livecast is brought to you by Fixers Living. Check them out on the internet at fixersliving.com or love them on the Facebook. Facebook.com/Fixers Living. Kitchen, bath, outdoor, joy. That's what they do. Hey everybody, welcome to the Sam Livecast. It's Monday, it's a fresh new week. We're all here excited to get going. We got a different thing that we're going to be talking about today. I'll give you a little hint. Good eye, mate. How's that? Is that good?
That's pretty good.
That was great.
It's not bad. It's not bad.
What's up everybody? Welcome to the show. TheSamLivecast.com is our website. We've got lots of great recipes and everything up there. You can connect with us via Facebook and Twitter and tell your friends. That's how we spread the show and that's how we grow, and we love you for it, so thank you very much.
I suppose we could hire a PR firm or something to spread the word for us. Right now this
we
seems
prefer to have everybody like else so.
Okay, so look, at a few things to get to, not the least of which is the whole Aussie thing that we'll be talking about in a minute, but I have to share something that happened to me and mom last night. So we're at UTC, for if you don't know, University Town Center. We go a little bit of shopping, and
You just said what the name was. It's a mall in San Diego.
Yeah.
What, I'd say 90% of the people that aren't listening don't know what University Town Center is.
I get it. You said 90% of the people that aren't listening don't know what it is. You're right. 90% of the people that aren't listening have no clue what I'm talking about. So we're at University Town Center, a big outdoor mall. We're walking around, we do our thing. We finish. It's about 8 o'clock. Both hungry, we decide we'll get something to eat there. We walk over to that new Tender Greens place. Have you seen that?
Yeah. There's a Tender Greens across the street from my place in L.A.
Have
you
eaten
there?
We go
there all the time. It's amazing.
So we went. There was about 14 people in line. We said, F it, I'm not going to wait for this.
Wow.
So we walked into the food court to try and see what we could eat there.
Mm-hmm.
There was not only was there nothing that I felt like I could eat and still be relatively healthy with.
Yeah.
But they've started this thing where one employee from each of the little kiosks stands in front of like their booth with a plate of things. Like the Chinese guys have got like orange chicken all cut up with toothpicks in them.
So
I guess, but it was creepy.
Really? Why?
It was weird. You want to try this?
Is it creepy at Costco when they give out samples? I don't think so.
No, but it's one spot. I don't know. You know, have you ever been to Cabo? If you've been to Cabo on a cruise and you get off the boat, you have to run that gauntlet of like a 100 people selling everything from like Mexico switchblades. Mm-hmm. The guy's got 50 hats on his head and maracas and the blankets and all that stuff.
He's talking like about Cabo San Lucas in Mexico.
Why am I speaking in code today?
You just said Cabo. I mean, everybody
know
knows
Cabo
what that is.
Cabo
I just want
Mexico,
to clarify.
Okay. So it felt like that. So we left there kind of skeeved out.
Mm-hmm.
And we decided, we'll go to now this new restaurant called Seasons 52.
Oh, I've been wanting to try that place.
Right. Mm. So my first observation, it's like a real restaurant. I don't really know what I was thinking. But it's dark and there's like leather, you know, banquettes. And the place was jam-packed at 8 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
Packed. I didn't want to eat inside. And as we're walking to the front door of the restaurant, they have a big patio. And there's a big giant couch area with a fireplace. Like that. How nice is that?
Yeah.
We decide we're going to sit down there. Nobody there. So it's all cool. We're sitting there. They come by. We order. I find a salad, a crab and asparagus salad that was pretty good that we had and that I had. And so we're sitting. We order our food. And then a couple other people show up. And they want to sit in this pod too. And I suppose it's a communal pod. I can't say anything about them.
Mm-hmm.
But go back to that picture. So right here is a chair that they could have sat in, and they could have sat right here. So they would have been like two cushions away from us.
Yes.
They didn't do that. They decided that they'd sit right effing up on our asses, right? So they're sitting there. Man, I was bummed by it, but it is what it is. Nothing I could really do. I mean, you know, what are you going to do? You going to move? I wasn't going to move. Mm-hmm. At least at that moment, I didn't want to move. And
did they know who you were?
Well, if they did, they didn't say.
Okay.
I have no idea.
From the look of that picture, they're not staring at him.
They want their food.
When people recognize him, you can tell. They're like,
but I might have just... So that has nothing to do with the story. Here's what has to do with the story. So it goes from this. Do you see the guys? Go back to that picture.
Yeah.
Do you see this?
Yes. That looks like a leg on the
table.
That's
a leg, right?
Oh, God.
Is he reaching out? Oh.
What the?
Guy puts his effing leg up on the table.
Where are you?
And I'm sitting there and I'm looking at that. See, this is, look, that's my,
that's
this is
disgusting.
My right knee, my left knee. This is the place where food's going to go, right? And the guy's got the thing there. I was already pissed that they had glommed so close to us,
that's
right?
That's bad.
Now his effing foot is up on the table. And I turn to Kelly. I'm like, I want to leave. I don't want to sit here. She goes, no. I go, I'm going to say something.
Oh,
she
man.
Goes, no, no, no. Don't say anything. Mom doesn't like confrontation. Fine. So no confrontation. I'm going to be fine. I'm going to sit there with this, right? Guess what happens next?
Hmm.
Now our food comes.
Oh.
Oh.
Right? So that's, Mom ordered a flatbread. Mom ordered the salad. My salad hadn't come next. So the server, I was going to say waiter, but they don't say that anymore.
Uh-huh.
The server comes down this path right here.
Yeah.
And this side of the table is close to those chairs, and he couldn't really get by. So he comes down here, makes this little deke around this chair, and he stands right here with my salad to put down. He has to reach over ass wipe's leg, and he says, excuse me, excuse me. He sits my plate down here. I didn't take a picture because
shut
I was
up.
Trying to be relatively. The plate goes down, and the guy doesn't do anything.
You're telling me that that waiter walked up to the table, and that guy just
kept the leg there.
Did he acknowledge that somebody was coming in?
I mean, he did nothing.
That is so rude.
And the plate goes down, and Kelly can see. I am red. I'm mad. I'm hot under the collar, and I'm pissed off.
Wait, I just want to clarify. That's a shoeless foot, right?
Yes.
Okay.
It's a shoeless foot.
That's a dirty sock on the
table. Both of his shoes were off, by the way. They were on the ground. His other foot was sitting on top of his dirty effing shoe. But now his other foot with the dirty, stinky sock, I'm sure it stunk, was up on the table. The guy puts my food down, turns, and I look at this creep, and I go, do you mind taking your foot off the table? And I went, oh,
yes.
No, of course. Like, he had to be told that?
Oh,
like how is this not ingrained into you?
I don't even know what to say to that. That just seems so glaringly inappropriate. I don't even know how somebody could think that that was acceptable. You know, I this is how what I was thinking.
By the way, I'm getting mad looking at this all over again.
That's so unacceptable to me that I thought that this guy was just going to be some douche who didn't care. I thought you were going to say something to him and he was going to be like, F you.
Right.
The fact that he went, oh, yeah.
Like, on some level, he knew that that wasn't right.
No, that means, I think that means he thought that on some level it was somewhat okay.
Oh, I didn't think of it that way.
He was,
I guess he does think it's okay.
Yeah, he thought
it
was fine.
I'm never going out again.
Restaurant etiquette. You
hate going out. I'm never going out again. I hate going out.
You hate going out.
I don't like the general public. I'm sorry. I'm sure many of you are very nice. But then this shit happens, and it just pisses me off.
Oh, man. Between other people and servers and bad food potentially, oh, it's just a crapshoot going on.
God. All right, let's get off that idiot. Have you seen this? The new McDonald's Egg White Delight McMuffin?
I have seen. I'm going to pull it back. I have seen.
Okay. And so it's okay. I mean, I don't have to take any exception to this.
Mm-hmm.
What I don't like is when further in the commercial when they show you how they make it, to me looks gross. That looks like a mayonnaise omelet or something.
That looks like an egg white pancake.
Shouldn't there be a little pepper, some green onion built into that thing, something?
Yes.
Give it a little color.
You know, as a food photographer, Sam.
Speak, Master Chef. Speak.
That, what that guy was doing when he took pictures, like, dude, there is no way we're going to make that look good.
And so don't do anything to
it? And
the
food stylist's like, yeah, we're just going to fold it up a little bit, and then, you know, it's going to be fine. And he's going to be like, no, that looks like crap.
There's no way to make this look good, so we're just going to do it. Like the douchebag last night going, there's no way to be cool about putting my stinky foot up on the table, so I'm just going
to
do it.
No, here's where the problem comes in. The guy took the picture because he was paid to do it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then the person that should be fired is the guy that picked the picture for the campaign.
Whatever food stylist, yeah, or...
No,
I'm surprised. McDonald's usually makes their stuff look good.
Yeah, anybody who got hired to do the job say, hey, can we make an egg white sandwich look great? He's like, yeah, we'll put a picture of an egg white in there.
How about we take a second to acknowledge the fact that McDonald's is trying to move in a healthier direction?
I suppose that's good. Thank you for bringing that up.
So
we'll give them credit for that.
I you know what? It looks the same as the big yellow one. I'd rather have a white one than the yellow one.
I don't know. I'll say this. I bought one of those boxes of just egg whites once.
Yeah.
And I was all excited to have eggs, essentially, without the cholesterol and make whatever I was going to make with it. Mm-hmm. I sort of looked at the whole thing like as my pass to eat basically anything I want as long as it's this little box of egg white is associated with it. Mm-hmm. And it was all great. I get the pan hot. I do some mushrooms or whatever, onions in the cooking in the pan. I take the lid off of this thing, unscrew it, and I start to pour the egg whites in. You seen what the egg whites just egg whites look like coming out of one of those things?
Something like that, maybe.
No, because they're liquid. It's clear.
Clear?
It's egg whites
like
are
translucent.
Essentially like translucent.
Oh no.
Gloppy, translucent liquid coming out of the end of this container.
Yuck!
Please, it was disgusting. I couldn't eat it.
All right. Well, let's get on to things that aren't disgusting.
Now I'm pissed off at everything. All right, here's what we have to do. Today we're doing something very interesting.
Mm-hmm.
A friend of mine. I'm just going to let her do it. Come up, Emily, come up here. So as she's getting into place.
Yeah, Emily. Woo!
Yeah.
Welcome to the show.
So as she's getting into place, this is Emily from the DSC, Dave Schelling Chainsaw, morning radio show here in San Diego.
Yes.
Emily's the producer of the show. She's been there for how many years?
12 years.
Wow, 12 years,
long
time.
They've been
on
the air 24 here in San Diego. Wow.
You've been half of it. It's amazing. It's amazing. So you like your job.
I do.
You get up early. You go to work.
That part kind of sucks. But once you get there and you're rolling.
What time do you have to get up?
My first alarm is at 4:30.
Your first alarm?
First alarm.
And the second alarm?
At 4:45 and then an emergency at 5 o'clock. I have to be in there at 5:30. Everyone rolls in between 4:45 and 5:30.
Wow. So it's important that you're on time.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So coming here half hour late today was not normally what you do?
Right.
It was awful. We'll call it an anomaly.
Sure.
Okay.
Sam.
You think you do a favor for somebody, they show up on time.
Solid.
Right? The Aussies I asked you to bring with you, they managed to come on time.
I know.
What's up,
and
guys?
And they've not even been drinking yet today.
Which is very un-Australian. Especially on a Friday, Monday morning.
Okay, but we have more important... Right, on Monday. Right, on a Friday. We have more important things to talk about. Yes. And the reason you're here...
Can I stop you really quick and just say you just made me feel so inadequate sitting on the couch? You.
Inadequate?
It's kind of guilty. You know I'm not the best in the kitchen. I've told you stories.
You've set your apartment on fire almost.
We evacuated an entire high-rise trying to cook.
Nice.
Cook chicken, just grilled chicken, and everyone had to evacuate. But I have one go-to dip that I make.
Yeah.
It's a garlic dip, and it's all white ingredients.
Oh.
And I had you try it at a party we were at 3 years ago. I'm like, look, I made something.
Did I like it?
You liked it, but you're like, but it needs color.
Apparently, I don't like things that are all white.
Exactly. And I have felt guilty for the last 3 years every time I make it because I'm like, Sam wouldn't approve. There's no color.
So put some color in.
But I don't know what to put in it.
So what's in it?
It's cottage cheese, cream cheese,
a
dollop of mayo,
and
garlic powder to taste.
Whoa.
Okay, so definitely some chopped up green onion would be good.
Would that change the taste of it?
A tiny bit, but it will definitely enhance it.
Okay.
Because I think it could use a little snappy bite like that in there. Master Chef, do you agree?
Wait, I just had an idea.
Yeah.
Sorry, do you agree, Lynn? No,
he's
I had an idea
Master
for
Chef.
Her. We're roasting some garlic right now. She could put up little chopped up bits of roasted garlic. It's a garlic...
Instead of the garlic powder.
It's a garlic sauce.
Yeah.
It's a garlic dip.
I might burn down my apartment.
You might. So just go with something
but
easy.
I've done well since you got me a pan.
Oh, good. Yeah. So what about this? What about red pepper diced really tiny? Little color would be pretty, right?
Yeah, I might chop my finger off. But
little. How about roasted... those roasted red peppers that come in a jar? That would be good.
I didn't
good.
Know that they did that.
Yeah, it'd be really good.
There you go. That's why you're the cooking guy. Sir.
That's why I'm the cooking guy, because I don't have it.
And I'm the cooking dunce.
No, I don't have any. I thought I did.
You always have a jar of that stuff.
I know. You know what I have that I haven't used yet? I've got these that she could actually put in them. Hot and sweet cherry peppers.
Oh, yeah. Ooh. Those are good.
What about these things?
So it'd be
but I'm just saying, but something, add a little color. It'll make it much more appealing.
Okay.
Appetizing
Clearly,
looking, right?
Because you were very turned off by the egg whites McDonald's were putting out there.
Like, we'll put them back up on the screen. They're disgusting.
It's
I hate
a floppy
them.
Flapjack.
Look at this. It's a floppy flapjack. It's a mayonnaise omelet is what that
oh,
is.
Man.
All right. Let's get to the important part.
Yes, yes.
Okay, so you're happy with your job.
Yeah, I believe I have one of the best dream jobs in San Diego. Right. It's a great gig. You have a great gig. We're really lucky people.
We're lucky people, right? Yeah, get up in the morning. I don't get up as early as you. No. Love what I do. Mm-hmm. Go to sleep happy, wake up happy.
Yeah.
It's all good. Mm-hmm. Okay, so tell me what has happened here that brought you here today.
Every once in a while, a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity
crosses
your plate.
Quit looking at them. You just talked to
me. Okay, I wasn't sure.
Yeah, you're good.
You don't have to you don't ignore the hell out of them.
I actually prefer this.
Okay,
I'm used to having a microphone when I talk to you.
Do you want one?
No, it's okay. And I was alerted to Tourism Australia's campaign to find people to fill the best jobs in the world.
So did they do this? Do I remember reading about this a couple of years ago?
We're looking at the site right now.
Mm-hmm. Oh, there you go. Okay, cool.
4 years ago, they gave a guy his own island to live there for 6 months and blog about his experiences while he lived the island
life. I heard about that.
Yeah.
It's a great, I have to say, it's a great, whoever came up with this idea.
Originally, it was Tourism Queensland.
I mean, think about it. Wow. They put this out there and thousands and thousands of people are spreading the word for them. They don't really have to do that much work.
No. Right. I mean, they're doing a lot of work this time around since they brought it back at such a high level, but they are getting definite return by all the people talking about Australia
right now. And so tell me the difference between last time and this time is the number of jobs they advertised? Mm-hmm.
First time around, they had one job up for grabs, and I believe they had 34,000 applicants, and you had to submit a one-minute video that time around. This time around, there's six jobs.
Yeah.
600,000 people worldwide expressed interest, which was the first step of filling out, like, the form. And then the second step was to submit a 30-second video.
Wow. Wait a sec. You fill out a form first?
Yeah, and then they send you an email explaining the details and the next step.
So then that 600,000 people all sent
all
in,
filled out
presumably,
a form.
Then sent in a video.
Well, then of those 600,000, 48,000 people actually sent in 30-second videos for the six jobs saying why they were the best candidate. And you could apply for one or all six if you wanted.
Do you know what that's saying about the other 552,000 people?
Lazy.
They're lazy efforts. Mm-hmm.
Here's a once-in-a-lifetime dream.
A once-in-a-lifetime job. I'll fill out a form for that, but making a video? No, that's too much
effort.
Work.
That's
unbelievable. Okay, 48,000 people sending videos for six jobs.
Yes. And so of those jobs, I'm going for the role of Chief Fun-ster, and that's based out of New South Wales.
Right.
And 20% of the videos were for that. So approximately 10,000 videos were going toward Chief Fun-ster.
Okay, so
Emily, is Sydney in New South Wales? That's the province it's in. Okay,
yes,
so that's like the main, or the largest, I believe?
Yeah, it's based,
Okay, so you fill out the form. You get an email back, you send in your video, then what happens?
And then you wait.
Then you wait
so
how
it
long?
So it was a five-week campaign to submit. Yeah. So people had 5 weeks to come up with a 30-second compelling video telling Tourism Australia why they were the best for the job.
Great idea. Let's watch Emily's video, shall we?
Yes, we have it right here, I believe.
This better be the same Emily.
Chief Fun-ster, shortlisted, baby.
This is you. Here we go.
Oh, here we go.
Uh-oh.
Oh, Lynn's blowing it with the audio.
That's me.
First dream job at 16, I've been blessed to experience a plethora of priceless opportunities. I reckon now it is time to shoot for the moon and conquer the best job in the world. My zest for adventure and making every moment count makes me your best candidate. Not to mention my passion for travel, music, sports, helping others, making lifelong friends in unexpected places, challenging myself, dressing up, laughter, adrenaline. My love of life enables me to excel in this position. Plus, I speak fluent social media. I was made for this job, buddy. I am your Chief Fun-ster.
Wow, nice. I like the video.
All right, so you send in your video, you wait 5 weeks.
Yes.
And then what?
And then you had to wait more weeks while they decided. Once the applications closed, they had 3 weeks to go through those 48,000 videos and shortlist it to 150, 25 per job.
Wow. No kidding.
Yeah. So
and you're on the shortlist.
Yes, I made the shortlist.
And so how did they tell you? Email?
Well, they said they had posted on Facebook that it would be announced on a specific date. It was Tuesday, 2 weeks ago. And
hey, hold on one second.
Oh, Lynn's got it.
We just
came down.
We just lost all our.
It's all good.
It's a very sophisticated studio that we have here.
I like it.
But you can see
your bed sheet fell. It's cool.
My bed sheet fell. Right.
You guys talk. I can come help Lynn.
All right. Cool. I think he's probably got it.
Okay.
Okay.
So. They had said that they just had on Facebook that their Facebook page, Australian Working Holiday, that they would be announcing it at a certain date and time.
Right.
So that particular day, it was a Tuesday here, it was Wednesday there in Oz, it was going to be announced at 2 o'clock. Yeah. And I remember it was 1:08, and I'm like, oh, I have 52 minutes. What am I going to do to kill time? Because I'd just gotten home, and I picked up my phone, and I was like, oh, checking my email, and there was from Best Jobs, congratulations in the subject.
I just got chills.
My phone dropped.
I'm not kidding. I just got
shaking,
chills.
And I just ran up and down my apartment.
Get
hallway
out of
going,
here.
Oh, my God. Wow. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Yeah.
That is so cool.
Yeah. I'd thought in my head I would check my email and the website with a camera on me just in case I made the cut.
Did you?
But no, it was 52 minutes early,
oh,
so
you
I wasn't expecting
that.
Because I would have loved to see what a maniac
I
looked like.
I would love
to
see that, too. I can only imagine.
Wow. Well, when I make the top three, we'll put a camera
on
me.
Okay, okay, so what happens now? What are you supposed to do now?
So they've tasked us for the last 2 weeks to generate advocacy for ourselves.
Yes.
Why we're the best person to represent said state, because there's six different states involved. There's
right.
a job in six different states.
Right.
And so that can be...
Will you get paid?
Yes.
You'll get money.
Mm-hmm. It's a yeah. $100,000 salary package.
50, what?
Yeah, 50 salary, 50 living expenses.
Got it, got it.
I dig that.
And you got to find a place where they're going to have a place for you.
That'll be part of the living package, I hope.
You'll just bloody sleep on someone's couch.
Exactly. Couch right? surfing is how you make new friends.
Do you guys say Chesterfield? No, it's just a Canadian. It's a Canadian. In Canada, uh-huh. Chesterfield means sofa.
Oh.
And I don't think that many people say it anymore.
No one
it's certainly
says sofa either. I feel like it's a couch.
Couch. Yeah, it's a couch.
What'd I say?
Sofa. Would you
He's
like
an
to
old
take
man.
A nap on my Davenport?
Yeah. Oh yeah. What do you say, couch?
We say
lounge.
Lounge. Oh.
Oh.
So I'll go lounge surfing.
Yeah. And just pocket the 50 grand.
Right.
You should.
Can I sleep on your couch? I'll buy beer.
If you come visit me in Oz, you can sleep on my lounge.
Okay,
absolutely.
Wait a sec. Wait
but
a sec.
But do not ask me to get you fosters.
Wait a sec. So I asked Emily to bring some Aussies with her. So we've got, from right to left, we've got Tim, we've got Megan, who pronounces it Megan, and we've got Blake. I have a question.
Yes.
Do you guys call it Oz?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, wait. You said yes. Megan said no. Tim?
We don't call it Oz.
I kind of do sometimes.
My friend welcomed me to Oz with a sign that said, "Welcome to Oz, Emily."
With an OZ?
Yeah, OZ.
Yeah.
See, I say AUS for
I've
sure.
I've seen it both
yeah.
ways.
But wait, if you said to somebody, where are you from, you wouldn't say AUS. You'd say Australia.
I'd say Australia, yeah.
Yeah.
How do you, so use AUS in a sentence?
This is like a really complicated subject.
It is?
Completely like unearthed.
Honestly, I just want to hear you guys talk.
Yeah,
I'm
seriously.
Not sure who has the funner sounding accent.
We actually do that all the time whenever we go out. People ask us questions just to hear us talk.
And what pisses you off more? Somebody thinking you're a Brit, a South African, or a Kiwi?
Ooh. Probably Kiwi, because there's Kiwi. That rivalry.
You have this rivalry. But yeah. It's a love-hate, right?
Yeah, it's a love-hate. It's like you guys in Canada.
Like a sibling relationship,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, yes. Like we do like that.
Yes, it is the same. The United States loves to hate Canada. That's
yeah,
the love-hate.
Yeah, you guys are a redheaded stepchild.
Right. All right, sure. So you now have to pimp yourself
yes.
as much as possible.
Yes,
so tell me what you're doing.
They've told us there's no right or wrong way to do this. It's whatever we feel is compelling and tells a good story about why we're great to encourage people around the world to travel to Australia and
right.
see all the beautiful things it has to offer on its own. So I have begun a campaign this past weekend. I went to the Belly Up.
Yep.
There's a great cover band that performs there on weekends. Atomic
Wait, for
Roof.
The for the Aussies
oh,
that
yes.
are watching,
mm-hmm.
the Belly Up is a bar.
Good. A bar.
Bar where you can drink.
Where you can drink beer.
Lots of beer. Right?
Yes.
You're going?
Fosters.
But wait, not Fosters.
Right, not Fosters.
Definitely not Foster.
It's like Bud Light.
So wait, is Foster's in the same category as Oz? It's something that
yeah.
people here think is done and drank,
yeah.
but
yeah.
but
Foster's
not really.
Is a myth.
Is Foster's
the first
an
Foster's
export?
I ever had was when I came over here.
Yeah,
that was the first one.
You've never had Foster's down there?
No, never, until I came to the US.
So favorite Aussie beer, quick.
Tui's new.
It's called Han Superdry.
I haven't understood ooh, I like anything that you've said.
I didn't get any of that.
And Han's Super Dry.
Han's?
Han's Super Dry. Tui's new.
Tui's new.
Mm-hmm.
And Megan?
Yeah. Tui's old.
Tui's old?
Yeah.
Darker later.
It's a black
that.
Beer.
It's darker.
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Well, here's the Han Super Dry right there.
Han Super Dry.
That's the one.
Yeah.
Which I would think would be Korean or something. Wouldn't you with
Han,
that name?
Han, yeah.
Han?
And I'm a Little Creatures Pale Ale fan.
Little Creatures Pale. Oh,
mm-hmm.
I like it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So you've done the thing at the Belly Up. You're going to go
on
stage. stage and dance?
I hopped on stage, danced, got the crowd involved.
Nice.
I found this incredible, picture the Blue Man group,
yeah.
those suits they wear,
yeah.
but it's an Australian flag. So he's been running around town with me, helping out
fine.
With some of the stuff.
And the guy paints himself like a...
No, it's one of those zip-up like
spandex
zip-up suits.
Yeah.
yeah. Mm. So it definitely catches people's attention and
yeah.
starts a conversation about what's going on and what I'm doing to spread the word about myself. Got up on the big screen at Petco Park dancing and got a message from the Padres in the outfield, which
wow.
was awesome.
Wow. Mm-hmm. You're doing a really
yeah.
good
you are.
Job.
You're stepping
you're
it
you're
out.
Pulling in
I like
every,
it.
I am.
Every producer of a morning show favor you could
I
think
am,
of.
Exactly. I have built these up for 12 years.
And here's what's going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
You're
going
to get this job. You're going to leave for Australia. Mm-hmm. And 150 people are going to be knocking on the radio station door going, well, Emily Lee promised me that I could come in and play with my band for half an hour one morning.
Exactly.
I get free plugs for a month.
Sorry.
Oops. Sorry. I'll be here.
Last week I made it onto American Idol. I made a sign and you could see my sign in the background coming in.
Wow.
And out.
No way.
You know what? Okay. If you go to your Facebook.
Mm-hmm. Facebook.com/ Emily Jane Maguire. And
we can see that picture?
Yeah. There's
wow.
lots of pictures. I did a whole little collage. I got
really?
To meet Keith Urban again because I'd met him about 12, 13 years ago.
Did you get him to say... And he's an Aussie.
Yeah.
Did you get him to say anything on your behalf? On your behalf?
You know, I asked... He wasn't familiar with the campaign, so he didn't feel comfortable not knowing what he was getting into, which I can respect because if someone just walks up and is like, I want to be a chief funster,
no,
will
here's
you say
what you
something?
Done. You should have just said, will you say on camera... Emily's awesome.
Oh,
she belongs in Australia.
That's what I had a line that said that and a cue card.
Did you say that?
And he at first got on board. He was like, yeah, okay, I'll do this. And then when I held the camera up, he's like, oh, I thought it was just on tape. And
yeah.
I was like, well, it's fine. You can just talk into the mic. He's like, you know, I'm not really sure what
you
this
know what
is.
The you know what your mistake was?
What?
The cue card. And
well,
I know I understand the point of it.
Right.
But I think
so
that makes that starts to make it too... Like two like
well, where
promo-y.
Were you last week?
I don't. You should have asked me.
I know. Dang it.
So here's Miss Emily at American Idol.
That was Lighty Keith
go.
Urban.
Yeah, Sam does a really good Keith Urban impression. You could just get the tape and.
Is he cuter in person?
Yes.
And there's it. Chief Funster Emily loves Keith
Look
and Oz.
Look at that.
Yep.
I really hope that calling it Oz doesn't come back to bite you in the ass.
It won't. That's what all my friends call it.
All right, good.
Yes,
well,
my friends
these
down
three
under.
Don't ever call it that, but whatever.
Not just Negan.
No, Blake was agreeing because I think he's just trying to be on your side about this. Tim was honest right off the bat. He said, no, we don't call it Oz.
All right, well, Blake's my boy then.
We don't bloody call it Oz. All right, so here today, you're here today so you can spread the word.
Exactly. Are,
if people watching, can they do something to help with your little... mission?
I encourage you to go to the Facebook page because I've posted tons of ideas of ways that you can creatively say, we believe Emily is the best. If you're a fan of the morning show, perhaps that we've gone out and had fun at an event, or through listening to the show, I've inspired you to do something fun. I would love for you to post a memory.
Facebook.com/ Emily J. Maguire.
Jane Maguire.
Jane Maguire.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's what the J stands for.
Let's post a link.
We'll post a link.
Perfect.
Yeah,
thank
that's
you.
Cool. That's
yeah.
great. Okay. So now let's talk about this.
Oh,
shit.
Yes.
Stuff. I mean, Vegemite.
There it is right there, everybody.
There
Emily Maguire, Chief Funster.
All right.
Yes.
Good girl. We're here for you, Emily, even
I
though you were half
it.
An hour late.
Yeah.
This gigantic
ever,
favor.
Ever
no, you won't
live
this
down.
Down.
That's all right.
So
that's why you get to sleep on my lounge. When you
bring up the couch, Mike. Let's hear real Aussies tell us how amazing Vegemite is. Yeah, before they start, let me read it. Vegemite, this is off of Wikipedia. Dark brown Australian, sorry. Vegemite is a dark
Thank
brown
you.
Australian food paste made from yeast extract. It's a spread for sandwiches, toast, crumpets, and cracker biscuits, as well as a filling for pastries.
For
Vegemite
what?
Pastries.
Mm-hmm.
Vegemite is made from brewer's yeast extract, a byproduct of beer. Salty, slightly bitter, malty, and disgusting. No, it doesn't say disgusting.
Oh.
It does say it's similar to bouillon. The texture is a smooth paste.
Oh, you know, I'm so sorry. I got this wrong. I told our Aussie friends that I tried it.
Yeah.
But we tried Marmite here, not
oh,
Vegemite.
Yeah.
It's totally different.
Different.
Totally different.
You know what?
One's British, one's
What
Aussie.
A shame. But
I'm
I
so
can
sorry.
Help. Max, reach down into that bottom drawer beside you.
Oh, yeah?
You have the camera
oh,
on
we
you?
We are not going to do this.
We all have to try this,
Gosh,
boys.
Just the
oh.
smell.
Turns out there's a Marmite in there waiting for you. And
no,
Max,
that's a Vegemite.
Vegemite,
no,
sorry.
Vegemite.
Max, and two spoons.
Wait. Oh. Can we flash my computer? Do you remember our reaction when we did this? Do you remember this?
We had the
Marmite. Do you remember
Marmite.
How bad?
Good luck.
You look like you're about to hurl.
Oh, gosh.
So you liked it, is what you're saying.
Well, wait, but that was the Marmite. That's what the Brits eat.
Oh,
right.
Man.
So this is Vegemite.
Wait, they're similar, are they not?
That's way more than you need.
This is disgusting.
If you just taste it on a spoon, you're going to have a bad time.
Yeah. No, I know. That's
everybody,
problem.
Get it on a spoon,
that's
boys.
That's the problem.
Boys, get yourself up on the computer. Get it on a spoon. Let's have it. Let's have a look.
Oh, no, we're doing it in here, Chief.
I have to see you,
that's
though.
That's the thing. See, they spread this. Okay,
I
so
have
the boys
to see
in there,
you.
Listen. Are you, Jesus. The boys were saying, okay, would you rather have us up or them? The people who are here for the show.
Well, get them in, too.
But oh, all right. I'll just put up all four cameras. Oh,
we don't have four cameras. We'll figure it out, but I want to see the people that are eating it.
Okay, so then would you rather have... Okay.
Let's just do it.
You're so brutal.
Thank you.
Okay. It looks just like Marmite.
How so much do you have on your
is
spoon?
Is it different?
Do not take a spoonful.
That's what
that's not
did.
What you're supposed to do.
What are you supposed to do?
Well,
you're
not,
you do not eat this on its own.
We're
it's
trying
like,
it on its own, everybody.
It's like
and don't wuss out.
Lynn's turning it upside down.
Yeah, because it doesn't come
trust
out.
Me.
Yeah, let's just show the little bit
you
of
could
the
drop a bomb on this. It
so that's
come
what's
out.
In there.
There you go.
All thank right,
you,
so.
Get some on your spoon.
Okay, our friends on the couch said we're going to have a bad time. I'm not sure if I agree with this.
We're because trying it the way God intended.
This is you're supposed to put it on bread with cheese.
We don't have bread and cheese.
All right, all right.
We have a spoon. Can we please eat this?
Yes, yeah, we can do this.
All right, let's go.
On cheers.
Three. And I don't want to see anybody what's out there. You
cheers.
Watch each other. One,
eight.
Two, three. Cheers.
Oh.
That's just not my...
Oh. Ah. Oh. Oh, my God.
What happens
it
here?
Just continually gets worse.
I can't swallow it. I don't
talk
wanna.
About you swallow that. Swallow
I don't
it. Swallow it. Swallow, she can't. You can go, swallow it.
I don't want
come on, be a big girl. You're going to move down there. You're going to have to
I'm
have
not going
to
eat it off a spoon.
Well, yeah. You're going to have exactly. to pretend you love it or something.
I went back for seconds, actually.
What?
Chief wants a little more.
The kids from Taiwan. What do they have in Taiwan that's like this?
They do have something just like this. It's like fermented soybean paste.
Ugh.
Okay, so I want to just explain to anybody out there who has no experience with Australians or no experience with this.
Yeah.
It's weird to us and not necessarily a flavor that we like because we don't grow up with it. In Australia,
right.
They grow up with it. This is what they have when they're kids. They have toast with some Vegemite on it and some cheese, apparently.
Here's what I heard.
So for us...
Breastfeeding mothers rub it around the outside of their breast. So when the child is right there, they get the taste of it right off the bat. With the milk. Is that an Aussie accent or is it a New Zealand accent?
That is an abomination.
It's not good.
Yes,
it's not good?
No,
it's not. Just stick with
it. It's points for effort.
I'm trying to help Emily in her quest. I want the people at Tourism Australia to see how far her friends will go because we believe that she is the right person for this job.
You know what I learned when I was down there over the holidays was... I don't mean this in an offensive way, but
uh-oh.
they talk lazy. Like you have to relax your mouth to speak proper Australian.
Oh, I understand.
Because
yeah,
I try to pronounce things too well.
Yeah.
And I try to be like Wollongong, and they'd be like Oong.
I didn't get any of the beers that the boys
right,
had.
Right.
That was pointless.
It's kinda like,
if you
it,
talk like you have a mouthful of marbles, you'll be good.
You'll be fine.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What were you gonna say, Max?
It's kind of like how the Brits say "in it."
In it, right? In
yeah.
it.
In it.
Yeah. Meaning, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, they have ta
not
for thank you.
Yeah, yeah.
My friend Ali says that. I don't know if he said it. Ta.
Okay, so let's crank the couch mic just for a second. Just let me ask these guys. So how long have you been in the States?
We've been here for about 8 months.
Yeah. Everybody
nice.
Same? Came together?
Yeah.
See how I said that? Came together? And
getting
what food can't you get here that you miss from home?
There's a lot of foods, actually. There's Vita Wheats, Wheat Bix, which is pretty much just crackers and breakfast cereal.
You actually miss crackers.
Yeah, it's funny that you don't have anything really similar. They're like very hard. And
did you say Wheat Bix?
Yeah. Oh no, Wheat Bix.
Oh, Wheat Bix.
Yeah, I've tried your Wheat Bix. They're quite different.
It's more of a cereal thing, right?
Yeah, it's the same principle, same idea, but different.
Okay, so forget crackers. Get onto something good, something savory, like. Do you miss meat pies?
Yeah,
yes.
Meat pies.
Do you eat a lot of meat pies?
Used to.
Yeah. But when you're there, it's a very popular... I remember being in New Zealand. I haven't been to Australia, but in New Zealand, you can go to a gas station just on the highway someplace,
yep.
and where we would have hamburgers and hot dogs you know, like at an AM PM thing, mm-hmm. they've got meat pies that you can get.
Yeah. And sausage rolls.
Sausage rolls, yes. What else?
Bread, actually.
Any kind of bread, or your bread's better, you're saying?
I'm not saying our bread's better, but again, like with the Vegemite, if you haven't been brought up with it, your bread's like very sweet.
Yeah. Oh, I see.
Their bread is very good, though. Yeah. But it kind of reminds me of Wonder Bread a little bit.
Oh, it does. Interesting. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Do you actually say, do you use, we know you don't say Oz.
Apparently.
You don't drink Foster's.
No.
Do you actually say, has this sentence ever left your mouth? Throw a shrimp on the Barbie.
We don't.
No. Mock American.
It's funny, you said that in an American accent.
All right, mate.
Crocodile Dundee has done us an injustice yet again. Paul Hogan, I mean, seriously, tourist campaign, that's completely right. false.
But you don't say, do you say Barbie?
Yeah.
You say Barbie.
Yeah.
They but throw love a shrimp the short on the bar- words there.
They love that's the short words. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
It's the shrimp part. We call them prawns.
Prawns, right. Mm. Do say this for me. that's not a knife. This is a knife.
That's not a knife. This is a knife.
Right. Isn't that within his line? That's not a knife. Now, this is a
you
knife.
You can see the pain when in his face it. I know. When he's trying
so
to say that.
Brutal.
He's like, please don't make me say anymore.
You have seen it or haven't seen it?
No, I have seen it.
Yeah. Everybody, you guys, Megan, Tim?
No.
You haven't seen it?
Yeah, I've seen it.
Don't they show it in elementary school there for us? Mandatory viewing? You have to watch Crocodile Bloody Dundee.
No.
Geez. Have you ever wrestled a croc?
I have.
Oh, yeah. I've definitely wrestled a croc.
Both wait,
of
what? Yeah. I definitely?
Wait a sec. Whoa.
Wait,
are you effing with me?
No, that was my first job.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I worked as a crocodile wrestler.
No, that's just bullshit.
It's not a bigger deal as it is in the States. Like, crocodiles are...
Wait, I'm just going to... Let me just stop for
He's
a second.
He's completely stone-faced, dude.
Wait. Are you fucking with me?
Yes, he is.
They're very
I thought, you know what I thought? I thought maybe there was some crocodile truth, and he was just stretching it out to be a wrestler.
He's just...
He's
just taking advantage
have
of
you ever seen? Wait, have you ever seen a crocodile up close?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes. Kangaroo, yes.
Yeah, everywhere. Everywhere.
Are they the scourge of the country?
Yeah.
They are.
Really?
They're not as lovable as we think because they get in everything, right?
Yeah.
Are they like our bears? They get into everything. The
no,
food,
the bears are endangered species.
No, wait.
They actually have gigantic claws.
Yeah.
On their and also they have a really powerful kick and they can hurt you.
Yeah. Yeah.
But Lynn, I've heard that kangaroos down there, they're like rats. They come around. They want to eat the food. They're getting into everything.
I was just saying your comparison of them and bears.
Oh, they don't do that.
They do that.
They're everywhere.
Yeah. Are koalas super cute? I hate to be so stereotypical.
Jesus,
I don't know anything.
Right, you are honestly embarrassing me.
Koalas have really sticky fur and they smell like weed.
I have Australian friends that I went to college with. You're embarrassing me.
I'm just asking the questions that the audience koalas? Wants to know.
Do you know what you'll love when you come to visit? Is their bacon. It's different than here.
Yeah. Oh, do you call it streaky bacon?
No.
The Brits do that.
Yeah, that must
but
be
their
them.
Bacon is...
Cool. Is it long or is it like a...
It's round.
It's round, like Canadian bacon.
We call it a rasher.
Rasher bacon, yeah.
That and crackle?
Crackling.
Yeah, crackling.
What's that?
That was good.
What's
I
that?
I had that on Thanksgiving. I don't really know what it was.
It's
it was just
a,
yummy
it's
goodness
fat
in my mouth.
Of roast pork.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Cracklings. Yeah.
I love the Aussie talk, but we really got to move on.
Okay, one more. What's the drinking age down there?
18.
That's good. It should be younger. Yeah, 21 is nicer. And how old are you guys?
I'm 22.
Yeah, that's good.
19.
I'm
23. Got it. So Megan can't drink yet.
No.
Does the act? Does your accent buy you the way into a bar? Bye.
I wish it did. It
All right. Well, so here's what's going to happen. I'm going to make something. I'm going to make an Aussie thing. I had to do a lot of research to figure this out, and I have my own version of it. It's called a Lamington.
Mm-hmm.
And as far as I can tell, it's pretty popular. It's a dessert. Is it very popular down there?
It is.
Good. Okay. Well, I hope I do justice.
Them attack the tray of Lamingtons at an Anzac party I was at last weekend because people don't make them here. And the Aussies I was with for Anzac Day were so excited to have their Lamingtons.
I'm a little concerned about one part of mine, but we'll be able to figure it out. Okay. I'm ready to cook. Boys, you ready too?
Ready.
All right, let's hit it. So here's what it is. They're called Lamingtons. And as far as I can tell, they're generally made with sponge cake. You dip them in chocolate and you roll them around in coconut flakes. Simple. But you know that
Oh my God.
You know, I'm not a baker. I'm not interested in baking. I wasn't about to make my own sponge cake. And I went to the store looking for one, and I saw one. They were kind of like the big bunt-shaped ones, and I thought, that's okay. I feel like I remember hearing somebody say that pound cake was something you could substitute for this, and I like pound cake because it's a little bit denser, so that's what I've done. I'm going to start with a Sara Lee pound cake. Just your basic, everyday Sara Lee that we're going to cut up, and you'll see how we do this. Alrighty then.
I'm surprised you haven't done this whole segment in Australian.
Oh, I know. You want me to do it? I can do it with my Aussie accent. It's pretty damn good. Oh, all right, God. So now here's what I need. I need a long knife. Not this one. I guess I'll use this one. So I kind of want this thing. I got to think this through. I'm making this up as I go, ladies and gentlemen, if it's not obvious, because I haven't made this before. So
Because
that's what we do.
Sara Lee makes a good pound cake. Look at that.
They do make a good pound cake, don't they? I love it. What I'm trying to do is square this thing off, because these edges are all flat edges on this thing. I want this. I'm going to try and make them not too big. Okay, I'm going to do this right here.
Wow, I'm so curious what this is going to be, because I literally have no idea what it's even going to look like.
All right, so watch. Both on half. Half. Okay, so if I cut this in half here, then I do this. And until I'm done, I don't want any of you guys telling me I'm doing this right or wrong. Just leave me alone.
Did you guys parents make this when you were growing up?
No, we just bought it.
Really?
We just bought it.
Yeah.
So like they have a saying, it says American as apple pie. Is this like an Australian dessert that you guys would kind of...
I'll compare it to that, yeah.
I hope this works, man.
So you're just cutting into...
So here's what I'm trying to do. Rectangles. I'm going to get 8, or I'm going to get 4 out of these. I got to think about this. I was kind of hoping... I thought it would make more, but I'm making it maybe too big. But that's okay. So I want to stick them together. Let me ask you guys this. Is this too thick for a Lamington?
No, that's pretty much perfect.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Okay.
There we go.
So this part, I got all this, but I'm just going to do this many. So right now, here's what this is going to be.
That's like my favorite part, man, the leftovers.
Yeah, isn't it good? You can do a lot of stuff with that, man. Okay. I'm going to put raspberry jam in this because I called Woody yesterday, or emailed Woody, and said, hey, man, I got Aussies coming. I need an Aussie recipe. And before he could write back, I figured out what I wanted to make. And he said, oh, good idea, but don't forget the raspberry jam. Is that good advice, you guys?
Nobody's never heard of it.
You know what? I'm going to tell you right now. They're going to be better with raspberry jam than without raspberry jam. I believe that. Because I love the idea of chocolate and the coconut and the cake and the raspberry jam in the middle.
Wow, what the hell are we making?
Yeah, wait till you see these things. Okay, hold on. I can hear you whispering over there.
Sorry.
It's
whipped
cream.
Yeah, but raspberry and the whipped cream in the middle.
You're thinking of a different cake.
Don't fight, please.
Maybe I am.
please, Aussie people, don't fight in my kitchen.
So this is sort of like a layered dessert, I guess.
It's like a layered dessert. Okay, so we got this part done. Okay. That was the easy part. Not that any of this is extremely difficult.
I was gonna say, there's a hard part to this?
No, well, it's just, you'll see. So now I have to make this chocolate. What I don't know is how, I guess the chocolate will harden somehow, but I don't know how.
This is bad, man, when you know you're...
I know. Okay, here's what I need. I need powdered sugar, like a cup and a half of this. Which I think I can just estimate with my eyeballs. It should be sifted, that much I know. Shit, sorry. Now I gotta find my sifting thing, which I really like to use, but it wasn't. I got it. So now here's what we're gonna do. Now that, we'll do this the right way. We'll go a cup and a half. If you don't sift this, it's it's going to be all lumpy, and that's not going to help anybody here.
No, it will not.
Okay, so we got a cup and a half of icing sugar in here. Jealous? You're jealous. Look how cool that is. I love this thing.
Looks like something from the olden days.
It is. My mom had one of these things. And unless you bake, you won't need one. And I don't bake that much. I probably shouldn't even have one. But
I hate those because they're impossible to wash and dry.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Okay, so we've got this here. Let me get this down the side.
There you go.
I need a quarter cup of cocoa powder, unsweetened, and I have that right here. I need some vanilla. It's very simple. You'll get when I get to the complicated part. I guess I should probably do the same thing with
you
this.
You are all over the place.
I know. Quarter cup, quarter.
So you're doing the same sifting thing?
Yeah, I'm putting a quarter cup in here.
Look at that.
You know, your accents are normally pretty good, but I'm not gonna lie, that one sucks.
That didn't sound bad, did it?
It's really bad, Dad.
Quarter cup?
I'm saying you're normally good, but that's not one of your best.
Bite me. Okay, a couple teaspoons of vanilla.
You should hear his Canadian accent, eh? Oh, yeah, it's that's so good.
That's all the vanilla that I've got. I wish I had more.
Yeah, sorry, Emily.
And now I need some water. Water?
Water.
Water. Water.
Talk lazy.
In honor of the Aussies, I'll use a red Solo cup to deliver the water to this.
Megan can't even drink.
It just means drinking is really all that means. It just means drinking. So this is now, as I've been told, supposed to turn into, oh crap.
I still don't even know where this is going. Can you kind of explain what you're going
to
be
using? Well, I can't explain anything until this gets where it's supposed to go. There we go. It's coming together. Okay.
It's supposed to turn into like a chocolate syrup looking thing.
It's turning into a chocolate sauce in here, right? Right before your eyes.
Got it.
Right? So here we go. Okay, so this is working. And now you just work this stuff down the sides so it all sort of starts to get into the middle. Okay, this is nice. I like this.
Yeah, it's looking good.
I mean, essentially that's all like chocolate is, really. It's like cocoa solids, sugar, and some sort of liquid.
Right. Thank you, Master Chef.
I had to pull a chocolate chip cookie out of my dog's mouth last night.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
How did it get in there in the first place?
Bad parenting.
Okay, this is nice. This is nice, smooth, right?
Nice.
That's what you want. Okay, so you've got chocolate here.
What's the next step?
Next step is this. I gotta clean as I go. Next step is right here. I need coconut. I'm sorry.
Six.
I'm sorry. That's really a really ugly shot. Coconut. Who likes coconut?
Love it.
Okay, we'll put a bunch of it in here. And now, I don't have like a drying rack thing, so I had to find this morning, and this came outside of a little pizza oven, electric pizza oven that you guys, my kids gave me a couple years ago for Hanukkah, I think.
Interesting.
So here's how this works, if I can do this. You take one of these guys, squeeze it together, it needs chocolate all the way around it. There's no clean way to do this. There's only a messy way. But once it's in, let the excess drip, because that will not help anything. And then it goes in the coconut.
Whoa,
that's gonna be awesome.
And this, ladies and gentlemen, is a bloody Lamington. Sorry, well, not a bloody Lamington, it's a Lamington.
Seriously?
Does this look right, guys?
Yeah.
It does.
Is the chocolate gooey or is the chocolate satin hard?
No, it's gooey. It kind of like seeps into the cake.
Interesting.
Wow.
You did it well.
Well.
It's better than your accent.
Look at that. Who's the man?
You're the man.
No, you didn't have to say that.
You're the man.
Well, let's see if I'm the man once I taste these things.
There's nothing bad in there. This can't be bad.
It can't be bad.
There's just no way it can be bad.
Let me just start a second one.
Oh,
I don't want to get that hand wet. This is the classic way of when you're breading something. You keep one hand clean and one hand dirty. If you got them both dirty, you're effed. Because what you don't want is you don't want chocolate all over the outside of these, all over the coconut, right? There we go. Hello? 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 Hello?
Good day.
Good day. Do you guys, you say good day, right?
Yeah.
That is something you say. Yeah. How do you say good night? Good night?
Good day.
No, you say good night.
Oh, good night, yeah.
Good night.
Yeah. Or just night.
Yeah, night.
Any other weird things that you guys say that we wouldn't know? Fadinkum?
Everything.
Do you say fadinkum? Fadinkum?
Not so much people our age.
Shit. Why do I only know...
You're an old man.
I only know things from back in the day. I think I saw it in a movie once or something. Wow, I've only made four of these guys.
I think,
Here we go, last one. We're almost there, everybody.
Little Ripper.
Little Ripper?
You Little Ripper.
What's a Little Ripper?
I know people say it. Megan says it.
What is it? What's it mean?
It's good. It's
like,
good.
If you refer to somebody as a Little Ripper?
Yeah.
Good
if
work.
Something good happens, you'll be like, oh, you Little Ripper.
What?
You Little Ripper.
So Devo.
Huh?
Devo.
Devo.
Oh yeah, Devo.
Devastated.
Oh, I'm Devo.
Devo, so
really?
Devo. Are you keen, mate? That's another one there. So you'd like that, Dad. Are you keen?
Yeah.
Keen?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know that.
You know what's up.
What do you think?
They look good.
They look good, don't they?
They look like Lamingtons.
They look like Lamingtons.
They too.
Okay. You guys want to try one?
Where are you going, sir?
Yeah.
I'm going to go over to these guys. I can't eat this.
Of course you can't.
Lynn, hop on one for a sec.
Do you want your own or do you want to share?
We can share.
Okay.
It's only fair that you guys get some, too.
Yeah, hop in for sure.
I want to try.
Get in here.
Well, here, I can...
I feel like we're on MasterChef or something. With the judges.
I love that show.
All right.
Okay.
So I don't know which way the...
where you packed it.
So this for sure, I think, if I do this...
Ooh, I like triangles.
I cut it the wrong way. Shit.
Did you cut it in half again?
I cut it in half the wrong way, mate.
It's okay, do the other
Okay, tell you what. So just tell me
you
take...
You cut it like that.
Just take a bloody bite, would you?
Yeah, you got the plate?
Yeah, I cut it.
Try?
No.
And?
I don't like sweets.
Can we pour
that
knife?
That's not a knife. That's a knife.
You got anything bigger?
All right, so while they're trying the Lamingtons, which let's get a verdict on it. Not you, you're not really Australian.
Yeah.
I'd like to know what the Aussies think. Don't spare my feelings. I've never done this before, but I'll never have you back if you say they suck.
Well, for something you made so quickly, it's actually very good.
Thank you. I think that's a compliment. I can't really tell, actually.
Take it as a compliment.
Sorry? It's doable. The cake's different. I use pound cake. I didn't use sponge cake. Maybe the biggest difference is pretty similar.
I think it's the raspberry that definitely was a bit different.
Oh, it was.
That's why it's usually
My Aussie mate told me, don't forget the raspberry. And I really like the idea of it. So.
Different good or different bad? Or just
it's good.
No, it's good. It's good. Good. Okay, so here's what we've learned today. Emily wants to be chief funster of New South Wales, Australia. Mm-hmm. Go to her Facebook, facebook.com/ Emily Jane Maguire. She's got things there that you can do. Somehow you can tweet with the Aussie hashtag in there and her name. And we're hoping that this happens soon and you get the hell out of this country.
Yes, exactly.
Is it a year or is it a six months? It's a 6 months deal.
Yes, and I want you to come visit, we promise.
Yeah, if you pay for me to come down, I'll be the first guy there. Thanks for hanging out with us. What's happening? I'm making a recipe of a neighbor's of mine, Peter. This great little tomato thing on Wednesday. The rest of the week after that, who knows what's going to happen. Thanks for hanging out with us. Tell your friends. We appreciate you watching livecast and spreading the word about us. We'll see you on Wednesday.
Thank you.
Bloody right.